Good morning, everybody. Thanks for joining us here on the web. Fish and Game officials say two snowmobilers were rescued last night after getting trapped on a flooded section of road along the Androscoggin River in Shelburne near Gorham. One of our U-Local users captured this video of the rescue. Officials say the men were able to sit on their snowmobiles to keep out of the water. Both men declined medical treatment. A Wolfboro mother is accused of driving drunk with her 3-month-old son in the car. Police say this is the second time in just 3 weeks that they have arrested 35-year-old Kimberly Pritchard for DWI. She is also charged with breach of bail. Officers say Pritchard's husband was in the passenger seat, but that he was also drunk. The child is being cared for by a family member, and police say more charges are likely. A Manchester man is accused of leaving his two 9-year-old nephews alone for days at a time. Police say 25-year-old Jabari Atura was put in charge of the twin boys for 6 months while their parents were in Nigeria. They say the boys were left to fend for themselves on many occasions with hardly any food in the apartment. Court paperwork says when the parents would call the uncle for updates, he said everything was fine. Atura would stop by every few days to drop off food, but rarely spent the night.
That's our understanding, and the kids were actually doing an amazing job of taking care of themselves and getting themselves to school and essentially maintaining their own health during that time.
Atura is now charged with endangering the welfare of a child. Authorities say they believe the parents truly thought the uncle was caring for the kids, and they will not face charges. The Attorney General's office has released its final report about a murder-suicide in Barrington last March. Investigators say Glenn Grassett shot his wife, Pauline, at least 7 times before killing himself. Their bodies were found in their home. Officials say the couple was in the process of getting a divorce, that Pauline had been seeing another man, and that Glenn had plans to move to Florida. Friends said at the time they believed the decision to divorce had been amicable. A home in Lee will need to undergo repairs after an accident sent a car crashing into the house. The incident happened yesterday morning on Randall Road. Police say the car was parked on a hill behind the house. When another vehicle bumped into it, it sent it rolling down the hill and into that home. As you can see, fortunately, no one was hurt. The rinks are in place and the ice is set. The Black Ice Pond Hockey Championships get underway today in Concord. This is the 5th year for the Black Ice Pond Hockey Tournament, and there are 91 teams signed up to take part. Some come in from all over North America. Games are all day today and tomorrow, with the semifinals and championship game on Sunday. The players do their own rink maintenance after every game, and the money raised from the tournament goes back into the Concord community.
And we've given over $100,000 back to the community, whether it's hopefully building a new skate house here at White Park or some other projects that have happened, as well as keeping the cost down for players to get involved in youth hockey.
Yeah, helping out the community there. First puck drops at about 9 o'clock this morning, and thanks to lights, the action on the ice lasts until about 8:30 tonight, and again from 8 tomorrow morning to 7:30 in the evening. That's it for your morning webcast. We'll have an update at about 1 o'clock this afternoon. Have a great day, everybody.